First of all, I welcome you all in today's session. Today I'm here to give you orientation about the particular skill. Okay, but before that, I would like to ask you a question, and question is, does the science subject teacher need specific skills? Yes, I want answers from your side.
Yes, ma'am.
Of course, means not only the science teacher, but other language teachers also, means the teacher of specific subject should need some specific skills which are really required for that particular subject. Okay, so can you tell me what are those skills? You can give me any example of language, you can give any example of the science teacher also. Yes,
illustration skills, questioning skills.
See, these are the common skills, means questioning skill, illustration skills. These are required, the mastery over all these skills, it is required for all the teachers. It doesn't matter whether that particular teacher is language teacher, that particular teacher is science or math teacher, or social science teacher. But I'm going to focus on the specific skills. And just give me one or two examples of the different skills or different specific skills which really needed to the teacher of the science subject.
The teacher should be able to make the child curious. Okay. The teacher should make the child think ahead, like what will happen if this is done or why it happens.
Okay.
Individual thinking should be initiated in a child. That the teacher should know how to do it.
Okay. So if you have studied the syllabus is there for the science subject under the 107. Okay. So there are different methods of teaching of science. Okay. And we can say that we cannot separate science subject without experimentation. Okay. So here we can say, here I only highlighted the skill of demonstration, because on this skill I am going to give you orientation. But apart from these, there should be specific. So as a science teacher, you should learn, you should inculcate different skills among you, and the one skill that is the demonstration skill. And of course, it is about experimentations also, it is about observations also. Means so many skills are merged in the particular skill. Okay. And why the particular teacher is using demonstration? Can you tell me the small difference between the demonstration skill and the experimentation skill? Or just give me difference between the demonstration method and the experimentation method. Yes,
ma'am. Demonstration method included the practical base, means experiment.
Okay. Just try to give answers. There is nothing wrong and correct.
Display.
Yes.
Display of.
In demonstration, we are just showing, and in experimentation, we are showing by doing.
See, actually.
Ma'am, in a demonstration skill, we are showing the demo on the basis of some concept, established concept or theory. While doing experiment, it is not compulsory that the theory is already established or not.
Actually, see, the main thing between the demonstration, even in demonstrations also, the particular person is going to do experimentation only. But here, the main difference between these two methods, or you can say the skills, the demonstration, it is teacher-centric, and the experimentation, it is student-centric. So whenever we are highlighting only on the experimentation, means here the students, we are assuming that the students are doing the particular experiment. And here in demonstration, the teacher is going to show any, going to give demo. Like us, so teachers are giving demo on different micro teaching skills. So in the classroom or even in the laboratory also, before performing experiment by the student, the teacher is giving demonstration of the experiment. Okay, and even in the classroom, for the better understanding of the different scientific concept, or you can say the scientific knowledge, I can say, because knowledge, it is in the form of different, there are varieties, there are different laws. There are different concepts, there are different characteristics, principles. So for better understanding of all these things, the teacher is going with the skill of demonstration. Okay, because all the time it is not possible to go with the experimentation. Sometimes we are not having that much, what are the materials or the apparatus needed for the experimentation. Okay, because experimentation, it is done by the students. It can be individually, it can be in a group. But here demonstration, it is only done by the teacher. So that this is the basic difference between the skill of demonstration and the experimentation. Or not, I will say that it is different. It is difference between the demonstration method and the experimentation method of teaching subject. Okay, now I'm going to tell you about the demonstration skill, and there are certain sub skills. Means every skill, it includes different sub skills, and I'm going to explain sub skills wise, so you will get clear idea about the demonstration skill. Yes, who will get the first sub skill? Yes, be interactive. Yes, students.
Aim of the experiment.
The first sub skill is aim of the experiment. I have enlisted here different aims of the experiment. Means how you should write, or you should tell the student the aim of the particular experiment before actual performing that particular experiment. So where it should be stated? Yes, when the aim of the experiment, it should be stated. Yes. Yes, before actual starting of the experiment, the aim of the experiment should be stated by the teacher, and it should be in clear statement. Okay, so I have enlisted different aims of the experiment to see how light is affected by lenses and plates of glass of various thickness, to determine whether sunlight affects on the growth of plants, to find out density of the water. Okay, so these are the different aims of the experiments, different experiments. Then the next is, yes, who will get the second one?
Selection of
parameters. Yes, so as you know that for performing any kind of experiment, we need different apparatus, we need different material. Okay, so demonstration means the teacher is actually performing particular experiment in the classroom, but before that there should be planning. So like before conducting your micro teaching particular demo on the micro teaching skill, you are writing your lesson note. That is nothing but your planning. So there you are preparing the presentation, PowerPoint presentation. That is nothing but your planning. So same thing is here as a teacher, what the teacher should plan about the apparatus, which apparatus she is going to use while performing the particular experiment. The apparatus should be clean. Yes, it should be clean. Then the size of the apparatus also matter. It should be proper. It should not be large enough. It should be visible to the class. It should not be large enough, or you can say small. It should be proper, visible to the all students, or you can say visible to the class. But sometimes what happens, we are checking that availability of the particular apparatus for performing different experiences. For example, but right now because of this pandemic situation, it is not possible for you also to make available different apparatus or the material required for the performing particular experiment regarding different concepts. Okay. For example, suppose if you are not having beaker with you, then do you find any option for this? Any other second option for this? Yes.
Glass.
Yes. So that is the another option. Means you have to find out in case of unavailability of the resources, inavailability of the apparatus or the material, you have to find out the another option for that. So instead of glass, instead of beaker, you can use the glass. Suppose you are going to take experiment of acids and bases. So for that, if you are not having different acids and bases with you, then what will you use?
We can use lemon as a acid, and for base we can use detergent.
Okay, means some material is there in your houses, so you can use that material and for doing the particular experiment. Okay, for example, suppose the burner is not there, then what you will use instead of burner?
Gas stove.
Yes. See, you are going to perform the particular experiment, so it is really possible to set up entire thing.
You can use the gas stove.
Yes. Any other thing you can use? You can use candle. You can use other lamps also. Candle. Yes. So again, instead of when there is unavailability of the material and the apparatus, always go with the other option which is there in your house. Okay, understood these two basic these first two points? Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. Yes, the third is use of organization diagram. Okay, so use of organization diagram means what? Whenever we are going to any perform any experiment, we'll take examples from different subjects, like physics subject is there, even chemistry subject is there. So as per the experiment, we have to plan that organization diagram. Suppose we are going to perform the experiment that is formation of carbon dioxide. Okay, so there should be organization diagram, means actually what you can say, the actual attachment of the apparatus or the material we are using for showing that experiment, that should be displayed on the particular. See, for that you can use the chart, you can use rolling boards, and you can see this will work in the physical classrooms only. So here you can use the charts, you can whatever organization diagram is there, you can display that diagram on the rolling board, and that rolling board you can hang on the wall, or you can use the PowerPoint presentation. Okay, so these things you can use for showing the organization diagram. So organization diagram means what? Arrangement and connections of apparatus and the equipments in the particular order. So if we see, there is a in the physics subject, there is a connection between the different devices. So one device should be connected to the other in which way, in particular sequence, that should be shown with the help of organization diagram. Okay, I have given different examples here: heat, electricity, optics, lights, laws of reflection of light, etc. Okay, so this is the one thing. The another thing is that when you can use another flow chart for that is also nothing but the organization diagram, and that is that flow chart is of procedure of the experiment. Okay, so whenever we are going to perform any kind of experiment, we are following certain steps. Step number one, step number two, step number three, and so on. So like that, the same procedure, stepwise procedure, should be displayed on the flow chart. Yes, in the form of flow chart, it depends on you how to display that particular procedure. Okay, so basically this is the best way to display the procedure in the flow chart. So again, you can display, or you can just make flow chart on the chart, on the rolling board, and on the presentation also. Okay, so here, what understood about this use of organization diagram? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
It is very simple. Yes, the next is skillful handling of apparatus. Skillful handling means this is also skill. The science teacher should handle all the apparatus. So whatever material she is going to use while performing the experiment, she should handle all the apparatus accurately, with carefully, we can say. For example, suppose the teacher is going to show the titration. Okay, and for that, the students are they going to observe the change in color. And she is holding that conical flask in a wrong way, then what will happen? Does the student able to observe the change in color properly? Yes or no?
No, ma'am.
Yes. Even while holding the holder also, it always matter where to hold the holder. Okay. So this is important for the teacher, that there should be handling of the apparatus properly, accurately, I can say. The next is student participation. Okay, so from beginning also, means from beginning of micro teaching, you are using this student participation. Now it's your turn. Tell me about the student participation. Student participation means what? Yes.
Interaction of students with teacher.
Interaction of student with the teachers. Yes, in student participation, there are two types of participation. Can you tell me what are the types of participation?
Active participation, where he also tries to do the experiment along with the teacher, following the teacher.
Okay, and the one more is there, that is?
Passive participation, where he only answers the questions to what the teacher asks.
Yes, see, whenever the teacher is going performing any experiment, at that time, in between, he is asking some question about what do you observe? Is there any change in color? Okay, what do you noticed? Okay, so if the teacher is asking such type of questions and student is replying verbally, that is nothing but the verbal participation of the student. And the second is active participation of the student. And whenever the teacher is going to perform, at that time, the teacher, she should take active participation of the student. This is very important in the demonstration skill. Okay, so where the teacher can take active participation of the student, what do you think about this? Yes.
Active participation can be done in small experiments which are not hazardous, and the materials are easily available at home or at the reach of the students, and which do not cause any harm to the students also.
Yes. The first thing is, whenever, suppose there is an organization diagram, and as per the organization diagram is whenever teacher is going to perform any experiment, so to make the connectivity, teacher can take active participation of the student, and even teacher asks the student to perform certain steps of the experimentation. Okay, so this is nothing but the active participation of the student, and it is very, very important in the demonstration skill. Means the teacher should ask questions in between, means she should take verbal participation, but active participation is must in the demonstration skill. Okay, the next is opportunity for observation. Yes. So what do you think about this opportunity for observation? Yes.
A teacher should ask what the students are observing.
Yes. Actually, so when the teacher, she is going to show the organization diagram, she is going to explain these are the certain steps of the experiment, and she should tell that in the particular step, the student should observe the certain things. Means here, you have to observe whether there is a change in color or not. Okay, suppose you are going to take experience acid and bases. Is there change in litmus paper? Color of the litmus paper. So the clear cut instructions should be given while explaining the flow chart of the procedure of the experimentation. Okay, so at that time only teacher should tell the student that where they should observe. So maybe they should observe the entire experiment. They have to focus on the entire experiment, but the more focus should be on the particular steps, or maybe at each step of the experiment. And what to observe exactly, it should be teacher should tell the student about what they are going to observe exactly when the teacher, she is going to perform the experiment in front of the class. See, here the students, they are observing different things regarding the experiments, and the conclusions of the experiments are always drawn on the basis of, yes? The conclusions of the experiments are always drawn on the basis of
results.
The conclusions and results. See, actually, the whatever observations.
Observation.
Yes. The results. See, conclusion and results both are same. So whatever result is there, whatever conclusions are there, conclusions are always drawn on the basis of. She is also right that results means the effect, whatever effect they have seen in the particular stages or the steps, we can say. And the final conclusion is made on the basis of students' observations. Okay. Then the next is creation of situation. So creation of situation means what? Yes. Suppose the teacher, while performing the experiment, for we'll give you example of density. See, I'm giving you different examples, and the same experiment you can use for this, taking this demonstration skill. So density. Suppose after adding lemon in the, suppose there are two glasses full of water. After adding lemon on one glass, the lemon sinks to the bottom, but after adding the lemon on the second one, it floats on the water. Okay, so initially the students, what they can realize that the both are glasses, they are filled with the water, but in the first glass it sinks to the bottom, but in the second glass it floats on the water. So why this happened? They should be curious to know the reason behind this. Okay, so such type of movements, or you can say the wow movements, should be created while performing the experiment in the class. Okay, sometimes they are curious to know the reasons. Suppose there is a change in color. Why there is a change in color? Why after in the first glass the lemon sinks to the bottom, and in the second glass it floats on the water. What is the reason behind that? So there should be the curious situation, and that is nothing but the creation of situation. Such type of situation created by the teacher while performing the experiment. Okay, understood about this? Yes or no? Yes, students.
Yes.
And the last two, that is time management. This is the micro teaching skill. So you're supposed to perform this experiment within time. The time limit is 5 to 7 minutes. And the last is, that is overall effectiveness of the lesson. So on the basis of all these sub skills, your teacher educators, they are going to evaluate you. Okay. So all these are the sub skills. Understood all the sub skills? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, it is very simple, but it is very challenging for you to select particular experiment, because you have to perform that particular experiment and you have to also take active participation of the student. So it is really challenging for you to select the experiment. Okay, so select very small experiment, so the material or the apparatus are easily available at your home, and you can select the same for the demonstration skill. Okay. Under